This is part of the Aiken Quadrangle. This quadrangle is about 60 square miles. We have quite a bit of experience mapping in the upper coastal plain, and we learned a long time ago that with this dissected topography that you have in the upper coastal plain, that you need approximately 60 holes per quadrangle. I pick holes of different collar elevations so that I can get the total section of stratified units from the floodplains to the lowest creeks up to the highest parts of the areas between the creeks. Those holes will be drilled from 60 to 80 feet as a rule in this area.
Joe Koch is the individual operating the drill rig. He's our driller. He had a lot of experience in a fairly short number of years with us, because that's about all he does. He can tell by the RPMs on the drill rig and the way the augers turn. He can tell differences in how much clay there is in the various sands, and he can even feel the gravel. If you run through gravel, he'll feel it on the dip. But then he's got to keep track of how many auger go on and off the drill stem, so that, you know, we're drilling 10 feet at a time most of the time.
Okay.
The other fellow in the orange shirt there is Ernest Howard. He's actually on loan from us, but he was a driller's helper with us for a good while, and he was real energetic and strong individual. Anyway, he's a lot of help to us because he does most of the heavy lifting. Melissa Craig is an intern with us, and she'll start classes at the University of South Carolina in a master's program this Thursday. And Will Dorr in the tan shirt, he's a geologist that works mainly in the coastal zone, and he's done an awful lot of drilling over the last eight years or so down near the coast. Well, it's a truck-mounted mobile rig. We auger into the ground generally in this area from 60 to 80 feet. We auger in 10 feet and we pull out that 10 feet, lay it on the ground, and I describe that 10 feet. Take a sample in my hand and look at it with a hand lens, through the length of that 10 feet. I know color changes. I make a notation of changes in the grain size of the sand, changes in how much clay there is, and I'm writing all this down on a log, and that log is the record we have for each hole. It has collar elevation and the date it was drilled and the total depth, and then a complete description of the layers that we penetrated and how the sand changed. And then we add 10 more feet of rod and go down, drill through the back end of the hole and drill another 10 feet, pull that 10 feet out. And so we do that at 10-foot intervals until we reach the target depth with whatever it happens to be in that particular hole. Usually we're looking for a specific stratigraphic horizon in most of these holes, so we won't stop until we penetrate that horizon, then we quit. This is the fall line here. Everything, it's the contact between crystalline rocks of the Piedmont and sediments of the coastal plain.
So it just kind of runs in a line from Aiken?
From Aiken to Chiral.
Okay.
And everything southeast of that line is coastal plain sediments. Northwest of this boundary, you're into crystalline metamorphic and igneous rocks of the Piedmont and up in this area, the Blue Ridge. So up in the Piedmont and Blue Ridge, we don't drill. The technique for mapping there, and we are engaged in a state map right now in Batesburg, and next year and this coming year in Emory, is to walk creeks, mainly because that's where you'll see the most rock.
Mm-hmm.
So you're trying to, in a Piedmont quadrangle, you walk traverses where you think you'll see the most rock, because you're trying to get as much data as you can. So that's, it's not that you're particularly interested in anything in the creek, it's just that that's where the most rock is.
This is a map covering all the quadrangles in South Carolina. Each has its own name. Each of it covers an area of about 64 to 66 square kilometers. Miles, excuse me. Well, there's 566 quadrangles in the state, and those are scattered strategically over the entire state. We go from the Mountain Bridge Jocassee area in the north to the I-20 growth corridor, the Lake Marion area, and we came into this area because there was no geologic map of that Pineville dump site that was set right on the lake. And then we've covered all of the area from Rockville to the mouth of the Savannah River in the southern part of the state. That's primarily to address the conflict between the rapid growth that's in that area and the sensitive ecosystem of the marsh.
We're looking for a pebble zone that marks the bottom of the formation, and that, I believe, is it.
So this is what you were calling
this
your
is what, this is what,
target?
This is what we're looking for. If I've got pebbles there, then the absolute base has to be within a foot or so.
Okay.
So that's good enough.
Now, how did you know to look for pebbles in that soil? Is that just based on prior drilling experience or mapping?
It's a characteristic of this formation throughout Aiken and Barnwell counties, all the way to Congaree River, really. And beyond there, I mean, if you go south westward to Georgia, this is one of the key markers in the upper coastal plain of western South Carolina. It's a pebble zone at the base of the Tobacco Road Sand.
Okay.
It's a real distinctive horizon. It's only a foot or so thick, but
it's very distinctive.
It's a key marker bed for East Georgia and western South Carolina.